One woman's line of teddy bears at teaching kids new languages.
Morado. Morado.
And an MIT student makes history on today's In This Together, presented by Ulta Beauty. Hey guys, and welcome to In This Together. I'm Sally Turner. For our first story today, one single mom is on a mission to improve children's communication. Dr. Tamika Maiden is a pharmacist, former teacher, and a single mom. Together, these experiences helped her develop and create Cubby Love Bears, a line of teddy bears that help teach young children Spanish.
A lot of times I get a lot of patients who are bilingual and or who only speak Spanish, and I have a difficult time communicating with them. So I decided to create this bear line for kids so that way they could have the foundation early on. They're sponges. They can pick up on things easily, quickly. And like I said, research states that when they learn early, it's something that they use for a lifetime. And it also helps them pick up on more languages as they become older.
The interactive bears teach children numbers, letters, colors, and other skills.
You simply click their paw and it lights up and it says the color in both English and Spanish. So it's a simple repetitive method. Each of my bears, they both speak the concepts in English and Spanish.
Okay, how do you say purple in Spanish?
Morado. I wanted to empower them through communication. You know, kids love teddy bears, so it's a cuddly friend. Some of them even sleep with them and you can learn with them. The parents are so thrilled about the line because, you know, it's something that has never been created to our knowledge. And the kids are able to learn two languages simultaneously. And research states that when kids learn two languages simultaneously, their cognitive skills are, you know, advanced. They have memory skills that are advanced.
Tamika has been encouraged by the bear's popularity during these difficult times.
A lot of parents have bought them, you know, to help kids during, you know, the pandemic, you know, crisis that we're going through because the kids aren't able to attend school at this point. What better tool to have than, you know, a bear that, you know, the kids can carry around, they can hug at home, and they play at their own leisure. So it's not a forceful thing that you have to say, you know, sit down and learn.
She wants other single moms with entrepreneurial ambitions to follow their dreams.
My advice to single moms and entrepreneurs is just go for it. When I first started the line, I was so afraid. I was so fearful, you know, that people wouldn't like the bears or, you know, the concept behind it. But like I said, once I had my baby, it just gave me that boost to just go for it. And you never know what's at the end of the rainbow until you start. When you have a child that looks up to you and that's behind you and a great support system, it'll give you that drive and that motivation just to go even harder.
And if you would like to learn more about Cubby Love Bears, we are going to be leaving a link to that in the comment section below. And for our next story, we have partnered up with Ulta Beauty to shine a light on beautiful moments of togetherness, joy, and humanity. For our story today, we are watching one college student achieve excellence at one of the most prestigious universities. Danielle Gaithers is making history as the first Black woman to be elected student body president at MIT. The rising junior hails from Miami and is a mechanical engineering major. Gaithers is honored to be serving alongside her running mate, Yu-Jing Chen, and to be president over the most diverse student body administration in MIT's history. I am excited about the opportunity to amplify underrepresented student voices and make the Undergraduate Association more visible as both a support resource and an efficient communication channel. Congratulations, Danielle. We are wishing you all the luck in the world for your future endeavors. So that is it for today's show. We hope you enjoyed it. And wherever you are making the most of these difficult times because we are in this together.